we've cheated death before, Piper. So why can't we do it again?
Because we can't.
Why would we risk that?
Maybe you should just listen to her. Well, maybe she should focus on collecting the souls so her death isn't permanent.
This is going nowhere.
Where are you going?
I'm not in the mood to lose another sister. I'm not doing this anymore. I give up. I quit.
But then you
can't
die.
Quit, Piper. Not until you catch up.
You can't make me take my sister's soul. I won't do it.
We don't get to decide who lives or dies. Only circumstances can change someone's fate. Life only has meaning specifically because there is an end. Death is what forces people to live.
Yes, but...
Which means that ending death effectively ends life. Throws off the entire cosmic design, the whole point, and for what? A single fleeting life.
I want to peel the flesh from their bones while they still live.
Okay, just because we're demons doesn't mean we always have to be so ill.
Yeah.
Just tell me how to defeat them.
See, whenever someone knows the future, you can always get the drop on them by knowing the future too.
Why are you not listening to me?
Names can disappear from the list.
Because this isn't just about me. Look, I don't want to die, but I'm not going to sit around and wait for an innocent to die either. And I think that's why I needed to take that sabbatical. To remind myself of that.
You give me my cousin's wife, and I won't kill you.
That's it? That's your offer, huh? No deal. Forget it.
In that case, I guess I'll just have to kill her.
What's going on? Why am I in this? Piper, do something. I can't.
Bitch, you better step right back into that body.
Piper, you can't do this. You can't take her.
Do you think I want to take her? I don't have a choice.
Where does that go? To where you're supposed to go. Don't be afraid. I'll be with you the whole way.
I must have earned back my powers somehow, or at least one of them.
You were being wordy.
We have to save Harriet.
Via!
Just die.
I'm human!
Yeah, even better. Lol.
Check your list. He's not on it. We changed the circumstances.
First, you want to stop a soul from moving on. Now, you want to add one.
Not add. Trade.
His soul for Paige's.
This is unprecedented. I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Ooh.
Your sister made a trade.
Whoa, bitch, slap of the century.
Talk about your miracle recoveries.
What the actual f-
What are you doing here?
Confirming my suspicions. Confirming that magic really does exist, even though I don't quite understand it yet. The catch is that I'm going to need your help with something even greater. I'll be in touch.
Man.
I care about you, BB. A lot.
I like you too. I just don't know where we go from here.
Maybe we should just see where it takes us.
That's how you end an episode. Yeah. I think it was a good episode. I liked the concept of it. I think there were some very, you know, standout moments, especially between Paige and Piper. I liked we got to see, I guess, the Angel of Death again, even though I have trouble pronouncing that. the enemy was just like blah, but he wasn't that important. He served his purpose, and you know, he wasn't, again, not the main focus, so didn't really bother me. Even though I kept thinking about some kind of reptile thingy when I was looking at him, but maybe that was, you know, the maybe that was on purpose. We also saw like evil Cordy again. I know she's not Cordy, but whatever. Got to see her, you know, I kind of liked one, some of her lines, and how she was, you know, she's just having a lot of fun. just rubs off or something. I do feel like I have to watch the episode where we first got to see Death again. You know, that was one of my favorite episodes, even though it's harder to, even though it's something that I'm not really looking forward to watching now, knowing what will happen to Prue later on. But I do feel like I have to watch it because I really understand what the rules are, because I have some, well, issues. I'm not sure if they're issues, but some things with the episode are a little bit like, I wish that wasn't really the case. And I'm not sure if that was already something that was, you know, canon or something that they changed. I don't know. But I'm a little bit iffy on the whole, you know, the list and that the things can change on the list thing. Like something about, you know, circumstances. If circumstances change, then people on the list can change. And some people are going to stay on the list, but other people can go from the list. That confused me a little bit. But I'm pretty sure that it's just me. I don't know. But feel free to explain. But I kind of like this strategy about, you know, if someone is supposed to die, you can't avoid it. You know, this whole lesson that Prue had to learn throughout the episode. You know, she was risking her life from time to time to prevent an innocent from dying. And she had to learn, she had to accept that you can't save everyone. And sometimes someone has to die. So it was a little bit weird that now we get to see that list. And we see people like disappearing and appearing. And, you know, we can literally make, you know, a trade with death. And like, I don't know, I was a little bit confused with that. But, you know, again, I only watched, like, most episodes only watched one time, including that episode of season 3. So, you know, again, maybe it will be more clear to me if I rewatch that episode. But personally, I just like, even though it's messed up, that if you're on a freaking death list, you know, you're gonna die. You can't do anything about it. And I know it's not that easy, as, you know, it's not like you can change everything. But still, it was just a little bit, you know, and again, maybe it's just me, but it was just a little bit like, wait, what? So we just do this and then this happens? I don't know. But there were still, you know, if I don't think too much about that, but focus more like on an emotional level, I think this episode did deliver. And I found it very interesting to see Piper as this kind of apprentice of death, even dressing as death. I liked, you know, seeing her do that, and even, you know, after she wasn't willing to collect Phoebe's soul, you know, she wasn't willing to, I guess, be a part of letting her sister die, but, you know, once again, after the talk with Death, she also got to that realization, you know, it's kind of same with Prue had, that, you know, if you have to go, you have to go, and I'm surprised that she got to that point in this episode. I really thought she would continue to, you know, want nothing to do with it. But when Paige was dying, you know, when we almost lost Paige, you know, she was guiding Paige. They were like this close to go whatever the heck that is. Luckily, you know, Paige was stalling, but I don't know. Like, even though, like, I don't know, I was kind of proud of Piper in that moment, you know. It was very hard for her, obviously, but she knew that she had to do it, you know. She knew that that was, like, the right way. But it's kind of upsetting that, you know, they could made a trade, and then at this last, like, what would have happened if Paige wouldn't have stalled? Like, I'm a little bit like, oh my god, if she wouldn't have stalled? But it went all right. Then we have Agent Brody, and I'm still, like, I don't even know with him. I did like that he was just sitting there waiting for Piper to come back to life, and he's just like, oh, okay, well, She was like, what the f-? He was so chill about just doing his little monologue, you know, just a little bit like, you know, I know this, you know that, I want you to do this and that, I can provide this for you, and yeah, gonna talk later. Like, okay, Agent Brody, like, it's weird. It's so weird. Like, I'm definitely more curious. I definitely want to know what's up with him. Because it does seem like he's gonna have, I mean, maybe, you never know with Char, but it does seem like it's gonna be a big part, maybe, of, like, the first half of the season, maybe the whole season, I don't know. I am more intrigued than I was last time, but I'm still a little bit nervous about initiative things, and Buffy fans will know what I mean. Wow, messy review. This. Can I stop with the Dutch? So in short, I think it was a good episode. There were some elements that I personally, you know, not really a fan of, but maybe I will appreciate more after rewatching the first appearance of Death. And I love that ending shot, you know, of Piper, Leo, Chris, and Wyatt. That's definitely, you know, one of my favorite ending shots. We need that. We need more like that. And I think that's it. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.